Do you feel like you're ever in a spiritual funk or you're never moving forward? That's what we want to discuss. I'm so glad that you joined us for our first ever YouTube video, and we invite you to subscribe and also to highlight the bell so that you will be notified if we do another YouTube video. You'll be able to watch it right away. We're going to look into Isaiah chapter 43, and we're going to discuss moving forward. Before we do that, it's important we recognize that as children of God, we have to be agents that are willing to change, or agents of change, promoting change in others and being willing to change ourselves. The children of Israel had experienced an incredible move of God when they were delivered from Egypt and bondage. Following God through the wilderness, He provided for them. It was a tremendous victory in the fact that chariots of Pharaoh were overcome in the Red Sea. Yet, for some reason, that was what they dwelled upon, and they did not look ahead. They didn't look forward. God wants to do something new, and He tells them about that in this chapter of Isaiah 43. It's easy when we don't move ahead to play the role of victim and get stuck spiritually and in whatever walk of life we might be in. Look with me, Isaiah 43. We're going to begin reading in verse 16 of chapter 43. Verse 16, listen to what Isaiah says. This is what the Lord says, He who made a way through the sea, a path through the mighty waters. It's as though Isaiah is saying, okay, this same God that you talk about, the one that delivered you, this is what He's saying to you right now. He also goes on in verse 17 to describe that great deliverance, who drew out the chariots and horses of Pharaoh, the army and reinforcements together of Pharaoh, and they lay there never to rise again, extinguished, snuffed out like a wick. Verse 18, forget the former things. Do not dwell on the past. See, I am doing a new thing. Now it springs up. Do you not perceive it? It's interesting to me how it's as though Israel is not able to comprehend that this same God who did miraculous things as He delivered them through the wilderness, He can still do incredible things. Yet it's as though they look back all of the time. You may be looking back at some things that God did. Unfortunately, you may be looking back at some things others did. And that caused you to continue to bring up your past as an excuse for never moving forward, be it in your professional or personal life or in your spiritual life. Again, let's pick back up, but let's go back and reread verse 19 again before we continue. See, I am doing a new thing. This is what God is saying. Now it springs up. Do you not perceive it? I am making a way in the wilderness and streams in the wasteland. As though He's comparing what He's doing now as to what He did before. See, the nation of Israel was kind of given this burden of sharing the message of reconciliation and forgiveness of the Father with the entire world, the message of salvation, and yet they were failing. God is telling them, this same one who delivered you before is now offering to deliver you once and for all. And we know that He is making reference and allusions to His Son who is about to come. He continues now in verse 20. The wild animals honor me, the jackals and the owls, because I provide water in the wilderness and streams in the wasteland to give drink to my people, my chosen. Again, a reference to Israel. Listen to these references. The people I form for myself, that they may proclaim my praise. Yet you have not called on me, Jacob. Another word for Israel. You have not wearied yourselves for me, Israel. You have not brought me sheep for burnt offerings, nor honored me with your sacrifices. I have not burdened you with grain offerings, nor wearied you with demands for incense. You have not bought any fragrant calamus for me, or lavished on me the fat of your sacrifices. But you have burdened me with your sins, and wearied me with your offenses. Through Moses, you see, God spoke at Mount Sinai and other opportunities that He had with the children of Israel to give them the sacrificial system, to put them in a right regard with the Almighty, to forgive sin. Although the sacrifices of animals, we find out, really didn't do it, it gave an allusion, if you will, or alluded to the fact that sacrifice was going to be made for everyone's sins, not just for Israel, but through all who would come to the living God. The new thing he was about to do was to provide deliverance through his son, Jesus. And he continues, listen though, you can hear him in those verses I just read, getting after his chosen, Jacob, Israel, because they're not continuing to be obedient. They're not continuing to practice sacrifices that are based on the law given to Moses. They are not doing what God has told them to do. Instead, they're looking back at what God already did for them, and they're sort of using that as making them good enough to already inherit the kingdom of God. They are forsaking what is desired by God for them to do right now. Sometimes we get in that habit too. We let that which has happened in the past bog us down, and it creates in us an inability to move forward and to continue to do great things for the kingdom. Listen to how this passage starts to close, and this will be the last verse that I want to share with you, verse 25 of chapter 43. I, even I, am he who blots out your transgressions for my own sake and remembers your sins no more. He's saying, you know what, Israel? Even though you have not honored me the way you were supposed to, even though you have not fulfilled your obligations of sacrifice and you have committed sins against me, I'm not going to hold your past against you. I am willing to forgive you. That teaches me and challenges me a great deal, because a lot of times we get hung up by playing the victim card and blaming others for things that have happened to us rather than forgiving them of whatever they might have done. They may have said something against you. Maybe it was a prejudiced statement. May have been something that just hurt your feelings a great deal, or a condemning statement. You need to forgive that person and move on so that you can experience a new thing from God. He's saying, look, I am willing to blot out your transgressions and forgive you for your sins. You need to do the same by forgiving your fellow man, your brother and sister. That way, I can do a new thing through you. So if you're stuck spiritually and you're not moving forward and you don't feel like anything is changing, it's probably because there may be some sin or victimization that you want to hold on to. Make sure you stop. Then and only then can you move forward in the forgiveness that is found only through Messiah. I want to thank you again for joining us on this YouTube video. Please don't forget to subscribe and be notified of our next one. God bless.